Hi, Pitufo Karpintero po. Ngayong araw na ito, pag-usapan natin ang Model HS7010 7¼ Circular Saw ng Makita. Unbox at review natin to. Makita Circular Saw. This is actually my first ever Makita power tool. Sobrang excited ako dito. I was supposed to review this right after ko mag-unbox. Well, that was the original plan. But then I thought, mas maganda siguro kung i-review ko siya after kong gamitin muna to for a few weeks. So then, here we are. After several weeks, ito na ang paborito ko na Makita. Ayos. So first question that you might want to ask is, why did I choose this brand, Makita? Well, the quick answer is because it is known for its durability, performance, and services. Hindi nyo na may tatanong, pero ang origins ng Makita kasi goes beyond a century na. They've been in the electric motor industry since 1915. So, naka-focus talaga sila sa mga motor, which is the main core ng mga power tools naman. At syempre, basta technology, Japan, Japanese products, yun yung mga unang pumapasok sa isip natin. They are mostly dedicated in quality talaga, and I think obviously, visible naman, na they are very proud of it. Kaya nga they gave us this lifetime service warranty. Kaya tip lang, never buy those fake ones in the market, ah. Only get the original products from Makita. Sobrang dami ng fake nito kasi. If ever you are unsure whether you're getting the original or fake, siguro just message me or comment down below and I'll be more than happy to help you. And let's verify it. Ang circular saw talaga kasi, I could say na it's a must-have sa mga baguhang DIYers tulad ko. Dahil nga newbie tayo, we do not have all the strength and stamina needed para tumabas ng marami at mahabang kahoy. Although sobrang delikado nito, with the proper usage and a good amount of respect sa tool, this becomes a very effective help body sa atin. Now, saan ba ginagamit ang circular saw? Ang circular saw kasi, it's a very versatile and efficient na power tool. Versatile kasi pwede siyang pang straight cut, pang cross cuts, pwede siyang gamitin sa plywood, sa mga hardwoods, 2x2, 2x4s, pwedeng gamitin sa wood joinery, sa paggawa ng mga uka. Basta make sure na sa kahoy nyo lang ito gagamitin kasi this is not advisable for metal use. I choose this model naman, HS7010 ng Makita, because first, I intentionally like the corded ones. So preferred ko talaga yan kasi I expect this circular saw to last for a long time. Kasi yung mga debateria, batteries eventually dries up and time will come na you will need to buy replacements. Ito kasi, you can just store this for a long time. Then, pag kailangan mo na, saksak mo lang, then good to go na. Then, finally, among all other choices available in the market, this suits my needs better kasi based na rin sa size and sa power niya. If I'm not mistaken, ito yata ang pinakamalakas among sa mga siblings niya, yung SH7000 tsaka SH7600, and even with other brands of the same size. As seen a while ago sa unboxing, the package includes the instruction manual. This is for safety, so please pakibasa yan, importante yan. And then we have the warranty slip, and then the Makita 40-tooth saw blade. We also have the rip fence and guide rule. And then we have the hex wrench, yung pangtanggal ng blade. Kaso wala siyang kasamang dust nozzle. At first akala ko hindi naman importante to, pero masyado kasing makalat. So if you know anywhere we can find one, let me know please. Pa-comment na lang. Itong power cord niya, makapal siya, and it is 2.5 meters long. Enough naman siya, pero I still use the extension cord for added safety na rin. And by the way, double insulated na din siya. So meaning, it is designed without the grounding connector. So wala na yung third prong. So this is the handle, and this is the front grip. So both are rubberized, syempre to lessen the vibration. Kahit na 4 kilos ang bigat netong circular saw, kayang-kaya siya i-control because of this. And it's actually very comfortable and of course elegant tingnan. You'll find the switch trigger sa ilalim netong handle. Malambot naman siya, and you only need one finger to squeeze this and operate the machine. And now, I really like this thing. Hindi ko alam ang tawag dito, pero it is very helpful and ang laki ng ambag niya when it comes to safety. Smart addition to. Here, you can find the lock off button. We use this para hindi ka nakasqueeze ng matagal sa trigger, just in case na you need to use it for a very long time. Pero I hardly use this though. Looking at its base, it's made of hard steel, stable naman siya, and it seems na matibay talaga. Okay, just in case na gusto mo mag bevel cuts, pwede natin i-adjust yung angle ng tabas niya by adjusting lang both of these clamping screws. So meron siya sa harapan at meron siya sa likod. All you have to do is loosen yung nasa likuran muna, and then adjust mo yung sa harap where you can also find yung angle gauge niya. Then sisikapan mo na both to lock it in place. We can also adjust yung height ng cut niya. We just need to unlock the depth gauge. We can use this lever, pull it up. Then adjust na natin to desired height na kailangan natin. Then push it back down to finally lock it in place. By the way, for safety, we always need to keep in mind na when setting the depth, dapat lalagpas lang ng konting-konte yung blade natin sa wood. Very few millimeters lang, 1 or 2. We don't need those extra blade height. Sobrang delikado kasi. Sa bandang harapan naman, you'll find the cutting line guide. This will be depending on what you're trying to do. Kasi, one is for 90 degrees, ito yon, and the other one for bevel cuts, yung pang 45 degrees. So basically, dyan lang tayo sisilip kapag tatabas tayo. Pero I hardly use this kasi I always use guides pag pumuputol ako. Ito naman yung rip fence clamping screws. As the name says, dito may lalagay yung rip fence mo, papasok mo lang siya dito. Na hindi ko rin naman ginagamit masyado. In this area, so inside this is the very powerful electric motor. This is a brushed motor, by the way. So not like yung mga bagong brushless motor ng Makita. We have to maintain this and replace yung carbon brushes niya as needed. Yun yung mga nakikita natin na nag-spark sa loob. Normal lang yan. Same as with yung mga amoy sunog when you first use it. Most common worry kasi ng mga baluhan. So dito siya pinapalitan. You just have to unscrew this, pull it out, insert the new one, screw it back in. So parang plug and play lang siya. Pero if you think it's a bit complicated for you, just bring it sa service center nila with the new brushes and they will change it for you for free. Pero actually, you don't need to worry too much about it naman kasi. Especially for DIYers na gaya natin, aabot yan ng maraming taon and it only costs for about 200 pesos siguro. Another great idea from them is to include a hex wrench holder. Incorporated siya sa body, so hindi na siya madaling mawala. You can see this in a lot of Makita products din. Ito naman yung shaft lock. We press this to lock the mounting shaft para hindi siya gumagalaw while we change the blade. By design, you'll see that we can actually utilize this flat surface. We can also take advantage of its weight para to have it seated and steadily in place. Usually, ganito siya pag pinapalitan ko yung blade. This aluminum part naman is the blade guard. Die-cast aluminum siya, so meaning molded siya from molten metal to its form. Kaya very durable siya and it should retain its form for a very long time. You can use this lever to safely turn it back and forth para malayo yung daliri mo sa blade. To install and replace yung blade natin, first, kunin mo yung hex wrench na nasa likod. Press the shaft lock. Mararamdaman nyo naman na nakalock na siya kasi hindi naiikot yung blade. Then, loosen the hex bolt. Pa-counterclockwise siya. Then, we remove the hex bolt and then also the outer flange. And then, we use this lever to raise the blade guard. When inserting the blade, we need to make sure the direction of the blade is actually correct to what's indicated here. And also, we have to make sure na tama yung size ng blade mo. For this specific model, it's 7¼ inches. Ang arbor size nito is 15.88 or around 16 millimeters. So, if ibang size ang nabili nyo, then you may also use yung mga ring adapters. Now, we have to lock it back. Hand tight natin ang hex bolt. Then, finally, always, we have to check kung naka 90 degrees ba yung blade natin. We can use the square ruler for this. Sa mga numbers naman tayo. Itong circular saw na to, meron siyang total power na 1,600 watts. So malakas talaga siya. With this power, kaya niyang umikot ng 5,500 times per minute. So kulang-kulang na around 100 na ikot yon kada segundo. Ang maximum cutting depth capacity niya naman, kapag straight cut lang siya, 90 degrees lang, it's about 67 millimeter or around 2.5 inches. Para sa bevel cuts naman, yung mga 45 degrees, siguro around mga 45 millimeters din. For the dimension naman niya, para sa length niya, it's around 11¾ siguro. And then for the width, it's around 9.5. For the height, kasama to, it's 10¼. Okay, so before we conclude this, bibigay lang ako ng mga additional tips when using circular saws. First, sa mga baguhang DIYers, kagaya natin, we need to avoid using circular saw freehand or yung mga walang rail guide. Okay? This is to avoid kickback, which is sobrang delikado. Next, it's also important na we always secure the wood. Pwede tayong gumamit ng mga clamps kasi ayaw natin gumagalaw to habang pinuputol natin yung kahoy. Best practice din na lagi natin i-visualize yung cutting posture natin. So, paano ba natin puputulin to? Along with that, i-clear na rin natin yung mga cutting parts to avoid yung mga tangled wires. To also avoid kickback and to avoid cutting anything else other than the wood, we always run the blade full speed bago natin idikit sa kahoy. Same goes when stopping it. We need to ensure na fully stopped siya bago natin iangat yung circular saw. Now, the most important of all is always treat this tool with respect. Alam naman natin na this can hurt us, so huwag na natin subukan hawakan yung blade pag umiikot. Circular saw in general is actually not the safest power tool. Pero, the manufacturers are doing its best to keep it safe. Now, it's up to us kung paano natin gagamitin ito.